Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube. I love the river, especially the Monongahela River. As an engineer for CSX, along the river is one of my favorite places to run. The Mon River has a lot of great history. It was once home to many steel mills. One is being preserved as a historic landmark, the Carey Furnaces. And still in operation is the Edgar Thompson Works, a little further down the river. Now, the area that I'm modeling is Duquesne. And in Duquesne, you'll find the Union Railroad has the coal docks. And the coal docks are home to the Big Blue Monster on the Mon. Now, this is a barge-to-hopper car transfer facility. And it's going to provide plenty of operation for my N-scale layout. So to model this, this is going to be like a 2-foot by 8-foot scene. The first thing I did was go to Home Depot and I bought 2-inch thick white foam. So I put down my Kato Unitrack and also some of the buildings that I scratch built and really laid out how I wanted the coal docks to look. I used a black Sharpie and a straight edge to pretty much draw out how it was going to be laid out and where to make my cuts. Now, in previous videos I do tell you not to use this white foam. The only way you can get away with the white foam is to use the Woodland Scenic's hot foam cutter. It's like a wire cutter. And if you try using a knife, you're gonna get those little white balls everywhere. That's why I avoid this. But because this actually was cheaper than the pink or blue or green foam, I used this. And I wasn't going to be doing any real carving like if I was doing a mountain scene. Okay, I flipped it over and I applied long beads of liquid nails. Now I made sure I got, especially around the edges, because the last thing you want is for it to come up. So I really used almost a whole thing of liquid nails just in the back of this. And then I took a piece of plastic and I smoothed it all out so that way it wouldn't have any high spots on it. It's all pretty flat. And I flipped it over, pressed it down, and just let it dry. You don't want to rush this part. I re-measured just to make sure it was 2 inches tall, and I measured the length because now I want to make those steel retaining walls. Now this is pretty much what this video is going to be about, is how to make some really cool river steel retaining walls. Watch this. Okay, looking at the retaining walls, we wanted something that has that same look. And the best thing I found is in Plastruct, it's G-scale corrugated siding. And I love using this stuff. So I measured it 2 inches tall, and I made, it's so easy to cut, because watch this, you just simply take your X-Acto blade, make a couple passes, and then you can bend and snap and it breaks off so easily. So I made a bunch of these and glued them together just with simple glue. And there's your retaining wall right there. Now using reference photos, I see that in the one corner it's slightly notched out, and that was pretty easy to do. I just marked it on the foam where it was to be cut. Cut that out, and then I used my Sharpie, outlined the back of it, took a straight edge, and like I said, it's so easy to work with. You just simply make a couple passes, and then you can just simply break it. And even at an angle, this stuff breaks pretty nice. And I'll be doing more work on it, but here's the overview of it. I had an N-scale ladder that I glued in. It fit perfectly. And this is just simple primer. I'm still going to go over with some brown paint and weather it, but just with the brown primer, I think this is starting to look really good. Okay guys, got more videos coming your way. Summer's winding down. That gives me more time in the garage. So subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains on here, djstrains.com is the website, and email is djstrains@yahoo.com. If you have any questions, ideas, suggestions, send me a message. And did you see how sunburned I was in this video? Yeah, that was kind of funny. I didn't realize how burnt I was until I watched this back. I'm like, holy crap, my red. So, but hey, anything for you guys. All right. Take care. Bye-bye.